Meet Merle Oberon, a Hollywood star of the black and white era, but forgotten in India, the country of her birth. Oberon was an Anglo-Indian born in Bombay in 1911. But as a star in Hollywood's golden age, she kept her background a secret. She passed as white her entire life. Oberon was inspired by the silent film actress Vilma Bánky. She got her start in acting through the Calcutta Amateur Theatrical Society. In 1928, she went to France after an army colonel introduced her to director Rex Ingram, who gave her small parts in his films. Merle's biological mother, Constance, who was part Sinhalese and part Maori, had her as a teenager. This is why her grandmother, Charlotte Selby, pretended to be her mother instead. Constance and Merle were raised like sisters for some years. Selby traveled with Merle to France. She disguised as her maid to keep the actor's South Asian pedigree under the wraps. Oberon's first big break came from Sir Alexander Korda, a filmmaker whom she would later marry. He cast her as Annie Boleyn in the 1933 film The Private Life of Henry VIII. Publicists for Korda had to invent a background story to explain her race. Marie Dilovsky, a documentary filmmaker, writes, and I quote, "Tasmania was chosen as her new birthplace, as it was so far from the US and Europe and was generally considered to be British to its core." Oberon soon became an intrinsic part of local lore in Tasmania, and for the rest of her career, Australian media followed her closely with pride and curiosity. She even acknowledged Tasmania as her hometown, but rarely ever mentioned Calcutta. As she bagged more Hollywood films, she moved to the US. In 1935, she was nominated for an Oscar for her role in The Dark Angel. After this, her performance in 1939's Wuthering Heights opposite the acting legend Laurence Olivier cemented her place in the industry. The New York Times said that Oberon had perfectly caught the restless, changeling spirit of the Bronte heroine. The late 1930s hurled Oberon to the so-called big league. Her husband Korda and veteran producer Samuel Goldfilm helped her assimilate, taming traits like her accent that would have given away her South Asian origins. But Oberon's secret weighed on her. Even though her light-skinned complexion made it easier for her to pass off as white on screen, she still often felt the need to silence frequent murmurs that she was mixed race. Film journalists of her era would note her tanner complexion. Some accounts claim Oberon's skin was damaged by skin whitening or bleaching treatments. In 1937, she was injured and her face was scarred in a car accident. Cinematographer Lucian Ballard, her then husband, famously developed a technique that lit her in a way that would obscure her blemishes. But the charade became harder to maintain. In 1965, Oberon cancelled public appearances and cut short a trip to Australia after finding the local journalists to be curious about her background. But she never admitted the truth in public. She died of a stroke in 1979. In 1983, her Anglo-Indian heritage was revealed in a biography, Princess Merle, The Romantic Life of Merle Oberon. The authors found her birth record in Bombay, her baptismal certificate, and letters and photographs her Indian relatives had. US-based academic Mayuk Sen, who's writing a book about Oberon's life, says that through his book, he hopes to convey the enormous pressures she faced as a South Asian woman, navigating an industry that wasn't designed to accommodate her and producing such moving work while fighting those battles.